Users always prefer snappy user interfaces, but how fast do you have to be? There are three main limits for computer response times, depending on exactly what type of user experience you're aiming for. 0.1 seconds, 1 second, and 10 seconds. The fastest response time limit is 0.1 second, which is required for users to feel there's no delay and that they themselves are directly making things happen on the screen. So, for example, that's how fast a slider should react when you're trying to move it. Let me demonstrate by hitting this glass. The text ding appeared within 0.1 seconds of the glass being hit, and that makes us feel that me hitting the glass is what makes the text show. On the other hand, let's say the response time is 10 times slower, so that it now takes a full second before the text shows. Now, with the 1 second response time, it no longer feels as if I personally made the text appear by hitting the glass. Instead, it feels as if the system is reacting to what I did. But as long as the result of the user's action happens within that 1 second, it still doesn't feel as if we have to wait for the computer to kind of get around to dealing with our request. So 1 second is good enough for the user to freely use the system and not worry about being slowed down by the computer. For example, we need web pages to download in less than 1 second for users to navigate the site freely. Unfortunately, the computer can't always produce results in less than a second. The third response time limit is 10 seconds, which is how long people can stay in the flow of the interaction, even while they're waiting. Let's try to hit the glass again. Actually, I cheated because it's just too boring to wait the full 10 seconds. But it's clear that once a response time is slower than 1 second, it definitely feels like we can't use the computer freely. Instead, we're being bogged down by the wait. So users hesitate to issue commands that will take longer to complete. For sure, people don't like to navigate websites where each new page view takes more than a second. So they leave those slow sites much sooner than they leave sites with sub-second response times. But users can wait up to 10 seconds for the completion of major actions, such as booking an airline ticket. As long as the computer is done within 10 seconds, users will keep their attention on the task and they won't forget what they were in the process of doing. They will think it's unpleasant to have to wait, though. These three response time limits, 0.1 seconds, 1 second, and 10 seconds, have been the same since Robert Miller defined them more than 50 years ago. And they will be the same 50 years from now. The reason response time goals stay the same is that they are determined by the human brain, not by any computer technology.